What's up, y'all? So today I'm just going to propagate into the realm, as always, of course. So, what do we have but a realm gone mad?
Give me a set. Frick it now! You're loaded.
So many things are taking place at this moment. When it comes to our civilization, we seem to be at a precipice. We seem to be at a fork in the road, really. It's like, do you go with the society even though you know where it's going, or do you split away from it, become your own entity, do your own thing, play the game as it's meant to be played? Some would say that's the better of the two choices, but I've been told ignorance is bliss, so you decide on that one. I mean, that really comes down to one's own perception about life. So, with that, what am I doing? Why do I propagate? Why do I do any of this? Is it for my ego? Some of it was. Some of it was for my ego. To say that, hey, look at me. Look what I could do.
Look what I can do. I can't stay mad at him.
Look what I know. But the other part of it was for a specific reason. Because I knew that the message needed to be said. It needed to be let out, so to speak. To coax the narration and nudge it in the right direction. And even though it seems like we are going to a point of no return, that's for a few, or for the masses, really. It's not for a certain group. A certain group has to go forth and propagate and cultivate anew. But everyone else who seems to be going along with the get along is, this is it. I mean, I don't say that as a fear tactic or anything of that nature. I just say that to point out what is the obvious. You got a society that's lost perspective on what is real and what is fake. You, real and fake. You've got a society that's just gone Looney Tunes when it comes to killing each other. Doing the most at tending to low vibrational affairs. It's just, it's maddening where we are today, you know? I mean, you look at the society that we came from, and from the 90s, from the early 2000s, and up until this point, and you see that progression. Well, it's not really a progression, it's actually a downward spiral. You see it. Our society, we had a society that seemed like it was going somewhere, you know?
The meltdown was prevented by technology first developed for Jamestown.
A nighttime raid by the U.S. military took the Iranians by surprise.
President Reagan refusing to bail out the Chrysler Corporation.
The U.S. hockey team failed to overcome the heavily favored
surprisingly close race. President Reagan appears to have won a second term.
Title, a wedding gift from the Queen, Her Royal Highness Camilla, the Duchess of Cornwall, is welcomed by the crowd.
The first space shuttle will be named Enterprise in honor of a fictional starship in the television series Star Trek.
The host of Jeopardy, Alex Trebek. Gorbachev's policies had the Soviet Union's economy in hyperdrive, expanding Soviet influence across the globe.
The Thomas Paine Space Telescope will be launched into orbit.
Missouri Arch has again declined to send troops to Kuwait after the small nation.
The United States is going to Mars.
And then, when we get to the 2000s on up to this moment, nothing. People are lost. People are scared. People don't know who to believe. You got people who are just doing crazy talk just to do it now. And it's like, what's the point of all of this? I have friends and family members who still talk to me about the programming as it stands and trying to hold a conversation about nonsense, you know? And I still pretend and I hold those conversations, but a lot of that stuff to me is just nonsense. A failed system that has a whole civilization egotistical, narcissistic, and low vibrational.
And in this mad, incredible dash around the globe, we decided to bring you the world's best of everything. It's all wrapped up in the ultimate countdown of the rich and famous.
Doomed to unfulfilled dreams and non-successes because they were too busy downing themselves to actually create. Too busy worried about the negatives, the risks, instead of taking them. But now look at us. Look where we are. One would say our future does look like the Demolition Man's future, and without the overly campy vibe, but that's what we've become.
Olé!
We're police officers. We're not trained to handle this kind of violence.
Weak society of do-nothing people, of know-nothing people who have no real talent besides having sex with one another, even if that is a talent anymore. Now look at us. You know? You think about it, you think to yourself, who do you have to look up to? And then you realize that the overall system that you've been given was full of people who were a part of an organization that wanted to keep the masses in a specific spot. Still does. And then you have people like me who, am I a person? Am I not? What am I doing? Why am I doing this? Why am I saying any of this stuff? Well, because I can for one, and because I'm creating for another. In all honesty, this society, this little bit of what we have right now, it is only being allowed to operate because of certain thoughts from my former life. Because of certain people who I care for. You know why I chose to wake up? You know why I wrote this in to the programming? You wanna know? Because I knew that, for one, I could handle it. When I woke up to find out what this society is, where it's going, all of that stuff, it's heavy. It's overwhelming. You can't literally sit up here and be a normal person when you know the civilization that you're a part of will come to an end. You know? How you tell folks that? How you lead that into a conversation with people? You don't. You just sit with it, really. Or you could just scream it to the high heavens and people will just look at you.
A leads to B, leads to C, leads to A. How can I make you understand, huh? A! There's an explosion in the 29th century. Debris from Voyager's hull is found in evidence. I go back in time to destroy you. B! You tried to stop me, disabling my weapon, which causes me to crash land back here in the 20th century. C! Someone in this century steals my time ship and launches. They go into the future. And once there, they make one critical mistake, which causes a temporal explosion that takes us all the way back. Tay, there's an explosion in the 29th century. The cycle of causality is complete.
How do you know all this?
I just go with it. Am I an entity that creates? Yes. Am I still MiKa’El? Yes. I mean, it's a vessel, it's a game, it's a light show. There's so many perspectives that you could look at this aspect of life, you know? You just can't get overwhelmed with it, even though it's very heavy.
There's that word again, heavy. Why are things so heavy in the future? Is there a problem with the Earth's gravitational pull?
What?
Even though it's a lot to fathom, you have to kind of just go with it. You can't overthink it, so to speak, because once you overthink it, mission's over. You've lost it. This is your story as well as mine's. You know? I mean, we are creating. I'm creating as I speak. You're creating as you speak, as you look. Does my video get shared or the likes that it deserves? Who cares? Do I care? I have all of the money I want. I am full of abundance. I've reached the pinnacle of my life. And am I happy? When I look past everything that I'm participating in, I'm ultimately happy. I'm very happy. How could I not? But I'm experiencing a life. I'm going through the hardships of that life to experience it. But again, we are getting to a point where some of us have to level set. We have no choice. It is our lease in life.
Kal-El, no! Kal-El, the last son of Krypton.
That's my name.
Remember who you are.
Tell me who you
say all of that to say this. This is a game. So you shouldn't be stressed out. You shouldn't be going through too much. And if you are, just know that that's the experience that you're choosing for yourself. Is it cold to say that we put ourselves in these situations that we find ourselves in? To a certain extent, some would say yes. But these are your choices. This is your life, and you are co-creating, whether you want to believe it or not. So, to my fellow co-creators, are you enjoying this life? What are you living for? My ultimate question that I always ask folks is, what are you living for? And when you can answer that question and not BS yourself, then either you are about to arrive or you have arrived. But this life is yours. So make the best of it or the worst of it. But whatever you do, just go with it. So, that message being said, a smile on and positive vibes your way. For the light workers, keep doing your thing. For the chosen, stay on mission. And for those who know, let's get it.